A lot of damage in many of these areas of Kentucky and also in the eastern parts of Tennessee, like around Knoxville, and more tornadic storms within the last hour or so into southeastern Missouri. What's going to be happening overnight? This is going to be our greatest threat at looking at more severe weather. We'll be looking at that developing in the red zone across the western Carolinas, southwestern Virginia, and more to come perhaps around Memphis, and Nashville, and Knoxville right through at least the early morning hours. After that, another very strong fast flow in the upper levels of the atmosphere will bring another strong disturbance on eastbound, linking up with a lot of low-level moisture, and that spells a lot of trouble during the upcoming afternoon on Wednesday and the Wednesday night for the big cities into the northeast. First of all, for the southeastern part of the country, we have seen our active weather, and we still have some tornado watches out, at least for the time being, that covers a good chunk of Kentucky and Tennessee, including the Nashville area, southern parts of Illinois, and southeastern Missouri, too. And this is the reason why. Look at some of these monsters still beginning to track their way to the southeast. Some of these storms, by the way, have been tornadic, also containing some very, very gusty winds, which goes without saying, and some blinding rains, too. Look at the rainfall again, returning to the big cities. This is round one overnight, but looks like the worst of your weather will be arriving mid to late morning on Wednesday into the afternoon hours. And you could be looking at quite a punch of stronger storms by that time period. Rainfall overnight, at least until around mid-morning, heaviest will be found into the western Carolinas, eastern Kentucky, and also into Tennessee. But midday and beyond on Wednesday, could be looking at another round of maybe some stronger storms reaching down again towards Memphis, and Nashville to around Knoxville, maybe beginning to dribble into northern Georgia, perhaps right around Atlanta again to Chattanooga, could be looking at maybe some more welcome showers for you. The farther to the north and east you go, you run into more problems. Now, Atlanta again, maybe some scattered showers, 86 degrees for you. Just plain dry and humid for Orlando at 94. Dallas will be at 95. Off to the New England states we go, looking at around the showers right now to your west. And here they come with one batch of rain, covering just about all of New York State right now, beginning to edge into western Mass and also over much of eastern Pennsylvania. Rainfall amounts here could be locally heavy again, central PA into western and central New York State. But it's going to be during the day on Wednesday with this strong system. Again, it's an upper levels disturbance, moisture in place, lower levels, upper level energy beginning to swing in from the west, and that is going to really fuel some big time storms as you go through the afternoon. Again, it's going to be this red zone, New York City, you're in it, Philadelphia, Harrisburg, down to Washington, to Baltimore, to Pittsburgh, to around Columbus, Ohio, and Dayton, too, in Cincinnati, could be looking at some very, very strong storms, which produce a lot of rainfall and definitely some damaging winds. That's going to be the big story right through Wednesday afternoon. Midwestern part of the country, you've seen a few storms this evening between Wausau and Green Bay and points to you north, including Sturgeon Bay. Wednesday's forecast in the upper Midwest was Chicago, a winter for you with a high of near 80 degrees, and the sun is back. The western seaboard, the west coast, not bad at all. Los Angeles, 74 degrees. Portland, you're back into the sun at 73 with high pressure control, but it's going to be this system right in through here, a system that will rocket eastward very rapidly overnight, heading towards the big cities by mid to late morning and also beyond, producing some more heavy rainfall for you. Look at the forecast lows coming on up. Very chilly throughout the northern plains and Rockies and much of the Pacific Northwest. And those daytime highs, another searing day heat-wise across the southwestern part of the country and parts of Texas, too. Besides all of the severe weather, we've got the tropics to talk about. Tropical Storm Aletta, this is the latest advisory, 8 o'clock Pacific Daylight Time. You can see the stats right in through there. Winds again up to 60 miles per hour, just below tropical storm force at the present time, moving west at 7. Looking healthier right now, and the trend is that we could be looking at maybe a tropical storm here within the next 12 hours. Weather Center is next.
Obedience school did nothing for me. I got sent out into the hot sun almost every day. Then one morning, we got a new Heil air conditioner. With Heil's 100-year heritage of dependability, I know I can count on quiet, efficient cooling year after year. Now it's so cool and comfortable inside.
Have you seen my other shoe?
I stay on my best behavior. My family says our Heil unit behaves even better than I do. Then how come I'm the one who gets to stay inside? Depend on Heil.
Call your local Heil dealer today and ask about their Quiet Comfort 2 gas furnace or heat pump.
Once again, a Subaru has received the highest possible rating in recent crash tests. The Legacy has beaten every car tested in its class. But the real story is that with our full-time all-wheel driving system, Subaru can help you avoid accidents altogether. The added safety of full-time all-wheel drive, number one in crash tests. No wonder the competition keeps beating their heads against a wall. Subaru, the beauty of all-wheel drive.
Continues to strengthen and may eventually become the first hurricane of the season in the eastern Pacific. Now, as of 2 o'clock Pacific daylight time, Aletta 14.6 north, 104.7 west, well south-southwest of Acapulco, Mexico, and moving out to sea at to the west at about 7 miles per hour. Top sustained wind 65 miles per hour, and the pressure is down to 994 millibars. Lots of cold cloud tops. And although we don't see an eye in this picture, it's a pretty good possibility that one will form as conditions are favorable overall for continued strengthening. And the official forecast is for Aletta as it drifts out into the eastern Pacific Ocean. The forecast is for the tropical storm, now tropical storm status, to attain hurricane status within about the next 12 to 24 hours. And winds increase to about 80 knots within about 72 hours. But again, the tropical storm now, hurricane later, probably continuing to drift out into the eastern Pacific. So that's the latest on the tropics and the latest on tropical storm Aletta. Back to the lower 48, we've got some heavy weather to talk about in East Tennessee, southern Kentucky. Showers and storms are moving through the northeast. There are a couple of thunderstorms also in Michigan, Pennsylvania, West Virginia, and a few severe storms now in Missouri approaching Jefferson City in the north central part of the state. Let's go to the northeast first, where the rain is widespread from the Hudson Valley and the Lake Champlain region south into western Massachusetts and Connecticut. Heaviest rains now near Springfield, Hartford, and south across Long Island Sound, over Long Island on Suffolk County for right now, seeing some pretty good downpours, while the heaviest rains have not yet reached Boston or Providence and are moving out of New York City. So New York, the situation for you today is another couple of showers here in the next hour or so. Then the rain tapers off. Clouds may part. The sun may shine for a little bit, at least partially. But then the atmosphere destabilizes and more showers and storms are anticipated later today. And they may come in when the atmosphere is at its most unstable in the late afternoon or evening. Severe storms are a possibility around New York City. So stay with us for updates. That would be, again, later this afternoon through early tonight. North central Pennsylvania, storms weakening, but there's a cluster of heavy storms now south, west and west of Pittsburgh, moving to the southeast. Low pressure now moving into the northeast. Another one in the western Great Lakes, heading quickly east on the fast jet stream winds. This is the wind shift line or low pressure trough that ends up in the northeast late today as it moves rapidly on those upper level winds in a west to east direction. As it hits the unstable air mass in the northeast later, it could be the trigger mechanism for those severe storms. Right now through the Midwest and Mississippi Valley, light showers. Arrowhead of Minnesota, near Chicago and Milwaukee. The rain gets heavier, parts of Kentucky and East Tennessee, but it's light in Milwaukee and again near the Windy City. Peoria's had a light shower in Fort Wayne, some light rain nearby, as well as Duluth, and just east of Minneapolis and north of Grand Forks. There's some light showers also in northeast sections of Kansas. These are the severe storms in Missouri. Cooper County, for example, under a severe thunderstorm warning at this time. Now back to the southeast, it's Nashville, nearby showers, Crossville, Knoxville. Showers have been heavy this morning. Lightning's been frequent. And now those showers and storms are heading over into western North Carolina, upstate South Carolina. The rest of the South is dry from the Florida Peninsula to the high plains of West Texas. And speaking of the West, showers now Utah to the Lake Tahoe region in California. And they'll persist off and on today. They may die out for a while early this morning, but the plateau will have scattered showers and storms this afternoon and this evening. Now here's the outlook for the Northeast. One round of storms going through, another one develops. Severe storms are also possible in the South, the Mid-South, the Deep South, hazy, partly sunny, and warm. Chicago clears up today, as well as Minneapolis. And in the West, showers and storms in Salt Lake, but dry weather in Tucson and Seattle. Cheryl?
Looks like a great weekend to stock up on the ice cream and the iced tea as the weather stays very, very warm over a large part of the country. 80s and 90s quite commonplace throughout the southern tier of states, with 80s bubbling northward over towards Washington, D.C. And then some blazing heat throughout the southwest with temperatures in the triple digits. Meanwhile, if you're not too terribly fond of the warm weather, the place to go is across the north. You'll find more comfortable readings in the 60s and the 70s. And we kick off this big holiday weekend on perhaps a very wet and a very stormy note over portions of the Great Lakes. There will be a smattering of showers and storms around Chicago back towards Cleveland and Detroit. But a great start to your holiday weekend across the southeast. Nice conditions for some golf or some tennis from North Carolina and South Carolina, southward through Atlanta, Tampa Bay, and West Palm Beach. But those showers and storms across the heartland will start to slide off towards the east on Sunday. And for the west, the same old song and dance. We have this huge ridge of high pressure in place that will keep it very dry and very stable, but also very, very warm throughout the southwestern states.
Well, stay with us. Your local forecast is coming up in just a few moments.
Let's see. Maybe hornworms, could be whiteflies, are those Japanese beetles or aphids? Oh, I don't want to know them, I just want them gone.
Try Ortho Bug Be Gone, Pete.
Bug Be Gone?
The one spray that kills virtually every harmful outdoor bug.
Every bug?
Guaranteed. Even insects others don't.
The bugs have gone to heaven.
Got bugs? Leave it to Ortho. And only Ortho has lock and spray. So now applying Bug Be Gone.
Thanks for tuning us in here on the Weather Channel. Again, a fairly active afternoon coming up as far as severe thunderstorm action. We think that mainly here in the northeast, right on down through the parts of the Ohio, Tennessee valleys and into the mid-Mississippi valley could be under the threat of severe weather. In fact, they will be. Big thunderstorms have already developed in parts of western upstate New York, northern tier counties of Pennsylvania, northwest PA starting to get some bigger storms, and some storms have developed even all the way back here into northern Wisconsin. We'll show all of those to you in just a moment. The setup here is a little bit unusual. It's what we call a northwest flow situation. In other words, the jet stream is coming out of the northwest here, and embedded in that, moving into unstable air, are several disturbances. We have them marked off by these dashed purple lines, which we call troughs. The reason they're not cold fronts is because there's not really a big temperature change, if any change at all, across the fronts. It is more of just a wind shift line, if you will, enough to converge the air, enough cold air aloft to make it very unstable. You add the strong heating of the May sunshine, and up go the thunderstorms. And indeed, that is starting to happen right now in western upstate New York, northern Pennsylvania, and we think eventually this could kind of queue up into a big squall line and race its way eastward. Could even become what is known as a derecho, which is a big wind blast from a big squall line that often moves through areas in the northeast. That has not happened yet, but we'll keep you advised. It could be moving through some of the big cities of the northeast as we head on through the afternoon. And you may say, well, wait a minute, it's just stopped raining in Boston, it's still cloudy, but the sun is going to break out in Boston. It already has in New York and Hartford, and that is destabilizing the atmosphere. A lot of folks think, after the sun comes out, oh, well, things are clearing up. It looks great. But all that's doing, really, this time of the year is helping to destabilize the atmosphere. If it stayed cloudy all day, you'd probably be better off, because that would keep the sun from really heating and bubbling things up. And look what's starting to happen out here to the west. Big thunderstorms are starting to develop. We'll show those to you in a moment. Wanted to show you here just north of Green Bay, actually a severe thunderstorm warning out here till the top of the hour, a few more minutes, and we'll have to, it doesn't look all that terribly severe on the radar, but there could be some brief heavy downpours and hail and gusty winds. We'll have to monitor Green Bay as these storms are developing in northwest Wisconsin and moving toward the southeast. And look what's happening here. There's our squall line starting to develop. That may be just the beginnings of a big, what we call line echo wave pattern, or bow echo, if you will, big squall line here. Again, Well, that's not a given yet, but it does look like it's queuing up into a pretty nasty squall line. Elk County, Pennsylvania, under a severe thunderstorm warning. Wyoming County, as we head up into New York, under a severe thunderstorm warning. This is racing to the east now. Watch out in Corning and Elmira, Cowdersburg, Pennsylvania, moving all the way over toward Binghamton, New York, and the southern Finger Lakes. A few showers around Albany. Looks like the rain, as I mentioned, is over for Boston, but the sun is coming out here. That is destabilizing the atmosphere. Flash flood watches in anticipation of some of the heavy rain we expect here in upstate New York, northeast PA, and because of last night's severe weather over parts of Kentucky and Tennessee. This severe thunderstorm watch, by the way, folks, is gone. That's been canceled as the severe thunderstorms earlier in Missouri this morning have fizzled as they've come into Arkansas. A last look at some of those big record highs from West Texas all the way into New Mexico, Arizona, and California and Utah yesterday could be setting up for more record highs in the Southwest today. And one last stop takes us to the tropics, where we have our first hurricane of the eastern Pacific season, Aletta, staying offshore but could strengthen.
Good afternoon, gentlemen, boys, and girls.
What's he doing, engineer?
Handles like a dolphin. Dolphin in our logo. Get it? Sea-Doo. Everybody's doing it.
To look at the best-selling boat in the world, visit your Sea-Doo dealer.
I need you to find these people now.
Okay, boys. Release the hounds.
Someone's been here.
Searching for someone at your car insurance company after dark? At Geico Direct, we're here 24 hours a day. In fact, one 15-minute call could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
Get the allergy report and everything else you need to know at weather.com. Well, almost everything.
Visit weather.com for everything you need to know to enjoy your garden. Well, almost everything.
Join Marshall Thies and Heather Tesh every
Sunday. Expect a chance of thunderstorms.
Also seeing some severe weather through the Plain States too. So the Plain States and the Northeast, that's where we're seeing most of the rough weather out there. We have an area of low pressure, actually several areas of low pressure here. Back to the south, along the tail end of a front, we're seeing some pretty nasty thunderstorms that have developed here across southern Kansas and the potential for more of those, Kansas, Oklahoma, into Texas. We'll start out in the Northeast, though, where we do have severe thunderstorm watches in effect, several of them. What we mean when we say severe thunderstorms is that you could have strong and damaging winds. We've already seen that with many of these storms. Large hail is a possibility, heavy rain, and lightning. So we're definitely watching this area for some nasty weather out there, moving through Pennsylvania, into Connecticut, into New York State. We have a number of warnings that are in effect for you here in New York, including Rockland County, Westchester and Putnam counties, and also into northern Jefferson County. So watch out for these storms here around Watertown, for example, one area that may be affected. More storms here moving through Ohio and through Pennsylvania. Where you see those reds and yellows on the radar, that's where some of the worst of it is. And once again, severe thunderstorm warnings for Rockland, Westchester and Putnam counties. So we'll be keeping a close eye on these storms, as well as into Fairfield County in Connecticut.
Connecticut. So we, again, have already seen some rough weather out there, and there is the potential for more, and a lot of nasty weather out there. Heavy amounts of rain, an inch or more possible from New York to Pennsylvania to New Jersey. And as we head a little farther south, we also have the potential for flooding. Flood watch is in effect Kentucky and eastern Tennessee. So look out, flash flooding is a concern for you here. Be careful driving in any of these areas. We're also watching rain and thunderstorms moving through the Great Lakes region, but also into Kansas, into the panhandle of Texas and Oklahoma. We could see severe thunderstorms here, and remember that severe thunderstorms can and sometimes do spawn tornadoes, so that's a real threat for you here. Definitely remain alert in these areas. Not seeing a lot of activity right now. Earlier we did have a severe thunderstorm warning in Kansas and Harper County, but we are anticipating more development, and that development could be in the form of severe weather. A little farther north, rain from Concordia southward to Wichita, and it looks like some stormy weather may be headed your way. Rainfall amounts an inch or more is possible here. Well, we head into the southeast, and you're also seeing some rough weather, especially into western North Carolina. Tornado warnings are in effect now in eastern McDowell County and southern Burke County. Again, a tornado warning in effect for both of those counties. Golf ball size hail has been reported with these storms, so you definitely want to act fast if you live in either of these counties. Get to the lowest floor of your home in a small interior room that doesn't have windows. Act fast. Again, the rain should be heaviest from western Tennessee back into Oklahoma and into Kansas. And this could be in the form of severe weather. We're expecting the threat of severe weather anywhere from the northeast back into the plain states. We want to now shift gears a little bit and take a look at what's going on in the eastern Pacific. We have a hurricane here, Hurricane Aletta, centered at 15 north, 106.1 west, winds 80 miles per hour. It's moving to the west at 6 miles per hour, and the pressure 984 millibars. Slow movement is expected to continue with this, and we will continue to monitor the situation for you here in the eastern Pacific. But you want to stay tuned. Coming up, we'll have more on the severe weather next in Weather Center.
She loves me. She loves me not.
It's that season. Love is in bloom, and so are your allergies. Not to worry. Tylenol Allergy Sinus relieves all these symptoms to give you complete relief, more than even the leading allergy prescription, so you can count petals instead of pollen.
She loves me.
Not. Tylenol Allergy Sinus. Take comfort in our strength.
It's allergy season. Be sure to pick up Tylenol Allergy Sinus.
Well, it's a scorcher out there today, folks. Here's one just...
AC not working? Don't go to extremes. Go to Penske Auto Center or Penske Max Air AC Recharge Service. We'll inspect and diagnose your system and replace your refrigerant so you'll stay cool. Penske Auto Center. It's the quality car care system.
Penske Max Air AC Recharge Service. Special $129.99 price. Includes up to 2 pounds of refrigerant.
Penske Auto Center. The quality car care system.
Last spring, there were approximately 1,300 tornadoes in the U.S. At any given moment, there's over 1,800 thunderstorms around the world. That's why we're here, with the most meteorologists of any network, to give you expert round-the-clock forecasting. So to find out if a gentle breeze will turn into this.
This storm watch is sponsored by Liberty Mutual, and we do have a lot of very active weather going on now in the middle of the country, including a tornado warning in effect for Baxter County in north central Arkansas. And we'll take a closer look at that in just a moment. Let's first of all talk about the overall setup. Has been an active day in the northeast and parts of the southeast. Most of the weather now in the middle of the nation, as we have cooler and drier air dropping down from the Midwest, interacting with very warm and very humid air in the southeast. And right along that boundary there, that convergence line, we are seeing some great big thunderstorms. Take a look at the difference in terms of humidity. When your dew points are getting into the 60s, it's getting humid. When they're in the 70s, it's downright oppressive. And that's exactly what we have here in the lower Mississippi Valley through parts of Texas, but very dry air just to the north. And again, right along that boundary, tremendously active weather. We have a couple of tornado watches now in effect for parts of Kansas, Oklahoma, very tiny part of Texas. Severe thunderstorm watch is in effect across Missouri, as well as Arkansas, and another tornado watch a little farther eastward now as we take you into Kentucky and Tennessee. I want to take a closer look at what's going on in these areas. We have great big thunderstorms right on top of Oak City. Look at all of that very, very heavy rain here. North and east of Oklahoma City, tremendously heavy rain. No doubt a lot of wind, probably some large hail too, right across 35 here. If you don't have to travel in that particular region, don't for a little while. These cells are moving primarily along towards the east here. And there certainly could be some flooding too, as there's a large area of very, very heavy rain, and it's not moving terribly fast. So you do want to watch out for that. And again, hail and a lot of wind, also a possibility. We take you into north central Arkansas. Again, Baxter County, a tornado warning in effect here until 11 o'clock local time. That's about 8 more minutes or so. And look at this line here, very tremendous line of thunderstorms. Wind is definitely going to be a possibility out and ahead of that line. You could see some large hail here too. Very, very heavy rain. Fayetteville looks like the worst is over at this point, but watch out in Jonesboro as these cells are moving primarily along towards the southeast here and may make it into your area eventually. And that is also going to be the case for much of north and eastern parts of Arkansas. Poplar Bluff, great big storms just to your north, and we've got more off to the west here, moving along towards the southeast again. So this is going to be a very active area as we go on through the night. And then we take you into Kentucky and Tennessee. Now, a lot of this activity has quieted down. Notice how this storm really, really started to diminish in intensity here. There is some heavier rain, some embedded storms west of Bowling Green, right along 24. Most of this moving south and eastward. And again, here there could be some hail or some wind. But for the most part, it looks like things are beginning to settle down in this neck of the woods. So there's your severe outlook right there, painted in red. We also include parts of the Northeast. It's been a rough day in the Northeast and the Southeast, and we have a brand new severe thunderstorm watch now in effect for central Virginia, southern Maryland here, parts of the Bay. We'll focus in on a couple of areas for you. Notice how things have settled down a good bit across New York. Bigger storms now moving out to sea. We've got more storms in and around the Philly area, southern parts of Jersey. Earlier today, there was a wind gust of 50 miles an hour and hail in the greater Philly area. And we are seeing more storms right along the Maryland-Pennsylvania line here. Watch out in Baltimore. You could see some active weather. That would be around 2 or 3. You've already had some active weather today. And there are great big storms. A little bit of a bow echo here in parts of Delaware. So there could be a fair amount of wind in southeastern Delaware and maybe towards Ocean City. So keep that in mind. And finally, we take you westward. We've had scattered showers in the Intermountain West through much of the day today. A lot of that is really going to begin to settle down as we lose that daytime heating. And our last stop takes us south and west of Mexico. This is a brand new hurricane in the East Pack. It's a very well-formed storm, very symmetrical, a lot of very deep convection around the center of the storm here, although it does not have a well-formed eye, as you can see. Latest coordinates, winds 90 miles an hour, 15.0, 107.2, and moving to the west at 8 miles an hour. Stay tuned. Weather Center's coming right up.
This program was sponsored by Liberty Mutual. For more information, visit our website at www.libertymutual.com.
You gotta stop right there. Good girl.
Today, I'm giving my daughter her first driving lesson. I'm Howard Simpson, auto insurance expert for Liberty Mutual. Teenagers are more likely to have an accident than anyone else. That's why I volunteer to teach kids road safety long before they get their license.
Let's go, let's go.
Whether it's teaching kids in high school or training professionals, we do whatever it takes to make roads safer.
At Liberty Mutual, we help you live a safer, more secure life. It's insurance in action.
You're never too old to learn.
Find out what the ancient tarot has to tell you.
The Empress card. She's pregnant.
No.
Yes, she is.
Is the baby mine?
Sorry, Mark.
She hasn't called you because she's having an affair with your new husband.
No. No!
Uh-huh.
I see from the Queen of Cups, he's still seeing his ex-wife.
His what?
Yes, he's still seeing her.
I'm seeing the King of Cups here, Frank. She's staying with her old...